So we all know ePortfolio sucks. Sometimes you're at a whole reflection, click save, and it all disappears. There's no notification system to let you know when your reflections have been sent back. There's no way to keep track of all the different things you need to submit. In this video, I'm going to solve all these problems with keeping up with everything as a dental foundation trainee, all in one free app. So welcome to our channel, and if you're new here, I'm Zoe. I'm a foundation dentist working here in London, and like most of you watching this video, I've had to deal with all these problems when I first started my foundation training. But I thought there must be a better way to stay on top of things. So I've been using the app Notion before for note taking and for organizing videos for this channel, and I thought it was a game changer. So I decided to make some templates in Notion to solve all these problems with DFT. So I'll start by briefly explaining what Notion is for those who don't know, and then I'll show you how I've been using it this year as a DFT and how you can use the whole system by duplicating the templates that I've made for you guys in just a couple of clicks. So the best way to describe Notion, I guess, is that it's a really powerful note-taking app that also uses databases and tables and formulas to organize your notes or workflow for your projects. And it does all of this in quite an aesthetically pleasing way. So let me show you. So once you sign up, you can either use the web app or you can download the app to your computer or laptop. So in Notion, you have these workspaces, and you can see I have quite a few here. I have one for the YouTube channel that I have, and I have a couple of personal ones. And in these workspaces is where you can make your notes, and you have pages. So here you can see I've made all these different pages, and the one I've made for you guys is the dental foundation training one. This is what it will look like when you guys download the template. So in this page, I've created loads of little sub pages for each section. And each of these sub pages utilizes either databases or to-do lists to get things done. And the main one that I utilize the most is this ePortfolio one here. So let's get into it and see how I use it. You can make the table look bigger by closing the sidebar there, and you can see the full table in view. So this is an example of a database table, and you can see each row is something that I've submitted or need to submit on ePortfolio. Each of these has its own page dedicated to it, which I can open and write the notes for the study day or the tutorial and write what I need to submit for ePortfolio. And I'll show you guys in just a second. These columns are all linked to the page here, and it helps you keep track of what you need to submit on ePortfolio. So generally, if you wanted to make notes on Notion, you can click the new button and it'll add a new row and you can start to make your notes. You add your title, your icons and things like that. But that would be quite boring and quite tedious to just write from blank. So what I've done is made you guys templates. So instead, you can click this button here, and these are the templates that I've made for each one. So I made a template for your study days, your tutorials, and for your reflections. So for study days, when I'm either there in person or virtually on Microsoft Teams, I open up a new page and the template opens up. So it automatically selects the type to study day, the status to writing, and it's got all the little boxes that we submit on ePortfolio for study days. And I can start to fill it in. So this is a study day for photography. And I can change the icon to a camera. And I can change the date to today because this is the day that it's happening. And if there's any resources like slides, you can upload them here. So throughout the day, as I have these templates here, I'm going to start making my notes. So they usually have a slide where they tell you what we're covering today. So I'll start to fill out the bullet points there. And generally throughout the study day, I make my notes in this section. And this is what I can use to submit on ePortfolio. So this saves me so much time because during the study day, I fill out all these columns. And then usually I would go home, change a few of the sentences, and I just copy paste what's on here onto my ePortfolio. This solves the problem of you writing on ePortfolio, there's the 30-minute timer, and you click save to save as draft and it all disappears. Even if that does happen, you've got all your notes still here and you can just copy paste them across. So if I go into one to show you, during the study day, I wrote down all the subjects that we were covering, I made my notes, and I made what I was going to reflect on as well. And all of this, I just copy pasted across to ePortfolio. So once you finish writing it and you've copy pasted it across to ePortfolio and you submit it, you can come to the status column here and change it from writing to waiting. This is when you're waiting for the ES or the TPD to confirm your submission. Once you've done that, you can come to this column here and click the date which you submitted it. And the reason we put the date here is because the next column uses a formula to act as a notification system for us to know how long we've been waiting and to check if the submission has been completed or not. So the formula in place is that if the status of a subject is waiting and it's been longer than 5 days, then the system will notify you to check your portfolio. So if it's been 5 days, it's going to remind you, you should check ePortfolio to check if it's been completed or if it's been returned to you. If it's completed, you can come to the status and change it to done, or if it's been returned back to you, then you can click it to return, so you know that this is the one you need to rewrite for some reason, and again, submit. And so for these ones, the system is notifying me that it's been longer than 5 days, and I don't know if it's been completed or not. So I'm gonna go back on ePortfolio, check if it's been completed. If it has, change it to done. If it hasn't, I'm gonna change the date to today, because now I know that I've checked it today and it hasn't been completed. So again, in 5 days, this will notify me again to go back and check it. If you guys prefer to have a shorter period or longer period, you can come to this formula and change the number here, and it can change it to 3 days, 14 days, whatever your preference is. And you can change the text that it shows here as well. Another way I use the notification system here is if I have a tutorial, I set the date to the date that I'm having a tutorial and I give a reminder. So I know I'm gonna have a tutorial on RPD design on the 19th, and I've set a reminder 1 day before. So 1 day before, it's gonna remind me to prepare for this tutorial. And I've made a really nice template for you guys for tutorials as well. So if you go into tutorial template, it will have 3 sections. So usually I have my notes here, so I prepare for this tutorial. What I learned during the tutorial, I make the notes here, and again, the reflection that I'm going to do on ePortfolio here. So everything is all in one place. You have your notes and you know exactly what you're going to submit on ePortfolio as well. And again, you copy paste this across. And the last template I've made is for general reflections that we have to do, and it looks like this. Again, it has all the things that you need to write in your ePortfolio, gives you guides so you can copy paste it across once you finish with it. And this is the main view. I've created some other views for you guys as well. So you can have a look at which ones you're waiting for. You can look at all the ones that you're writing or return. So these are the ones you need to write and work on and submit. And there's one for tutorials and study days and reflections. So this was the main section, but there's some other templates I made for you guys as well. If you go into the homepage, the next one is the ePortfolio checklist. And this is how I keep track of everything I need to submit. So for our scheme, I'm in the Northwest London scheme. They gave us a document which shows everything that we need to submit. The month of November I'm in, I know that I need to do a case-based discussion with my ES. I need to do 2 more reflective logs and 2 more tutorials, and all of this is there. The ones that are orange are the ones which need to be done by your ES and submitted by your ES. So this allows you to prompt them so they can do it for you as well. And in some of them, there's guides for you to keep track of. So by the end of May, you should have completed this many reflective logs, ADEPs, and case-based discussions. So this section lets you keep track of everything that you need to submit. If we go back to the homepage, in the notes section, you can make general notes which aren't related to the ePortfolio. So I've got one for each supervisor where I write down the tips that they give me. And when I was preparing for an endo, I made some notes as well. So I can keep track of all of them here. The next one is something I made for phone triaging. So whenever I'm doing phone triaging, I have this open up on the computer. There's some general notes which are taken from the Scottish guidelines, which guides me on that kind of questions to ask. And you can check out all the notes I have on there here, but I mainly use this section over the phone. So for example, if I think they have acute pericoronitis, I open the tab and I know what advice to give them exactly. So feel free to use this whenever you're doing phone triaging. The next one I have is on guidelines. Generally, when I'm at work, this is the page I always have my Notion open on, just so I have quick access to guidelines whenever I need it. So for example, if I'm prescribing something, I can click on this one and it will take me to the Scottish guidelines for prescribing in dentistry. Or if I quickly need to do a peri-diagnosis, I can just open up the peri-flow chart and it's all right there for me. This mainly saves time so I don't have to keep Googling things and everything is just in one location. And a really good one I have is for trauma. So the IADT released new guidelines in May, but the guidelines is portrait, but all the tables are landscape. So it makes it really difficult to read and understand. So what I've done is I made my own PDF with a table of context that you can just kind of click on and all the tables are there for you to read. So feel free to use these for trauma cases as well. And the last thing is the clinical experience log. And really, there's no easy way to do this. We need to submit these every single month. But what I've done is I've created a document which I print out. And every day as I complete something, I tally everything up. Once I've tallied it for the week, I come into Notion. I open it up and I add all the numbers here. So once I finish adding all the numbers, it calculates the total. And this is what I need to submit at the end of the month on ePortfolio. So you can do this either weekly or you can just print off this one document that I have here. You can tally them up at the end of the month and add it to your ePortfolio straight away. It's completely up to you. So of course I showed you all the templates with my stuff in it, but the template that I've created for you guys is completely blank. So you can start with the ePortfolio and everything will be blank for you and you can add your things as you go. And the way you guys can duplicate this and create your own account is if you click the link in the description, it'll open this up on your webpage for you. And you can click the duplicate button here and it'll ask you to make an account. And once you make an account, the template that I made for you guys will be there. So I hope you guys use this and find it useful. I know it's been a game changer for me and it's really helped me keep track of everything that I need to do. If you do find it useful, I'd really appreciate it if you gave us a like and subscribed and share this video with your friends who are also in dental foundation training so that they can benefit from it as well. Thank you guys so much for watching and I'll see you in the next video.